Hello, this is Colin Goble. This video is intended to give you more insight into how to break a larger, more complicated program down into individual functional modules. These are known as functions in C++. In order to provide the motivation for this demonstration, I'd like us to consider the casino game of craps. Now, I realize many of you won't have played the game of craps, but the essence of the game is that it involves rolling a pair of dice on a table, on the casino table, and the question is whether the sum of the numbers that come up on the dice, obviously the minimum number is 2, and the largest number that could be the total is 12. If that number, if the game depends on whether that number is repeated more frequently than the number 7 comes up. I didn't express that very clearly, and it's not at this point terribly important, but the important thing is the game involves rolling a pair of dice and considering what the total number of pips on the two dice rolled is. Okay, so in this case, I've designed a number of functions which will help us with our program. At the beginning of the program here, you'll see that I provided the function prototypes. We're going to have two functions here. One function called roll a die is going to simulate the random rolling of a dice on a casino table, and it returns a value of type int. As you'll see, it'll be one of the six numbers, 1 through 6, but from C++'s point of view, it's a value of type int. And as we've seen before, I have a function called abort program whose sole purpose is to put on the message on the screen, press enter or q to terminate the program. This pr doesn't return anything at all, so the return type for that function is void. Let's look at abort program first. I put that at the end of this source file. The function prototypes, of course, just like the table of contents of a book, appear at the beginning. But the details, the implementation of abort program, appears at the end of the program. It's down here. So it's a very simple function. It prompts the user to enter a line, it reads it into a string variable called line, and when the user does that, the program terminates. Notice, by the way, the scope of the variable line is from the point of declaration to the end of the code block in which it's declared, which in this case is right there. That's the scope of the variable line. In our program, there's another variable line. It appears in main right here. The scope of this variable line is the remainder of the function main, which goes on down through here. In this case, we have two variables called line. They're both of type string, but they have different scopes and they're completely different from one another. The line that's in abort, the string line that's in abort program has nothing whatever to do with the string line that appears in the function called main. The two variables with the same name, but non-overlapping scopes. Okay, the next method I want to look at is the method called roll a die. It returns an integer in the range 1 to 6, and it does it as follows. There's a built-in function in the math library. I've included the math library at the beginning here, pound include cmath, that's the include of the math library. It has a function called rand, which generates a random number in the range 0 to a very, very large number indeed. If we divide that by the number 6, remember that the percent operator gives us the remainder when we divide a number by 6. The remainder on dividing any number by 6 is going to be in the range 0 through 5. So if I add 1 to that, you'll see that die becomes a randomly generated integer in the range 1 through 6. We then switch on the value of that die. Remember that the argument of a switch statement can be either an int or a char. In this case, it's an int. And we have several cases 1 through 6. In each case, we tell the user what got rolled on that random roll of the die, and we return that value. Return die returns that integer as the return value of the function roll a die. Notice, by the way, that each case ends with a break statement. Otherwise, you'll get some output like you rolled a 1, you rolled a 2, you rolled a 3, you rolled a 4. We need to make sure that each case is individually self-contained, and we do that with the break statement. Okay, having done that, we can then use these functions in our main program. We're going to ask the user if they want to play the game that they signed up for. We'll read their reply. If they didn't answer anything, we're going to take that as being a yes. Otherwise, we're going to get the first character in the string that they entered. So line.at0 returns the 0th character of the string in line. The 0th character is the first character because characters in a string number from 0. So, if the user enters nothing, we'll take that as a Y. Otherwise, we'll take the very first character and we'll switch on the char because that char will be the first character the user entered. If they entered a lowercase n or a capital N, we'll bid them farewell and abort the program. If they entered a Y, we'll welcome them to the game and we'll break out of the switch, which will cause the flow of control to go on later into the main program. And if they don't enter an N or a Y, we'll also abort the program with an error message. Now, once they've entered the program, we need to seed the random number generator. SRAND is the function which seeds it, seed rand, and we'll seed the random number generator with the current time of day. We do that by running the time function, which is in the cTime library. The reason that we need to seed the random number generator is because without it, the random number generator will generate precisely the same sequence of random numbers every time we run the program. And of course, if you generate exactly the same number of same sequence of numbers every time you run the program, the numbers aren't going to be very random. So we need to start the sequence with a newly generated random number every time we run the program, and we do that by seeding the random number generator once and once only at the beginning of the program with a statement that looks like that. As I mentioned earlier, there are two die in the game, so we have two ints. We'll roll a die. The first time we roll it, we'll assign the number 1 through 6 to die 1. We'll call the function roll a die again. We'll assign the value that got rolled to die 2. And in the game of craps, the so-called point is the sum of die 1 plus die 2. So the point is the total number of pips on the two dice that we just rolled. Now, the rules are such that if the point happens to be 7 or the point happens to be 11, the player wins. If the point happens to be 2, 3, or 12, the player loses. Otherwise, if it's none of those, we keep rolling the dice again. And we have a do statement here. In fact, excuse me, it's a do while statement from here to here. We ask the user to press enter to roll the dice. We roll the two dice again. We calculate the total. And if the total is equal either to the point or the number 7, the rolls of the dice cease. But all the time the total on the two dice is not equal to 7 or the point, we keep rolling. The way the game works is if the total is equal to the point, then the player wins, and if the total is anything but the point, then the player loses. It's a complicated game. I won't go into the details. I'll let you look them up on the web. The purpose of this is to show you how to use functions in C++, and also to show you how to use the random number generator and various other things that we'll look at later. So let's just play this game one more time. I'm going to run the program. We will play the game of craps. As you can see, I rolled a 4 and a 5. My point is 9. So if I roll a 9 again before 7, I'm going to win. Let's roll the dice. That was a 3. That's neither 9 nor 7. In this case, on the second roll of the dice, I rolled a 6 and a 1. The total is 7, so the player loses. I've lost this particular bet because the 7 came up before my point came up for a second time. 7 came up before 9. Press enter to quit, and that's the end of the program. Thank you.